Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Amy of BushBaby Amy, and today I will be doing a Chit Chat Get Ready With Me. So this is actually my first Get Ready With Me, and I wasn't ready for how long it was gonna take. So grab your snacks, hit that subscribe button, turn on those notifications, and without further ado, let's head on over to the video.
Okay, what I've done to prepare my skin for this face beats that's about to go down is I have used a face wash and a day cream, and the day cream that I used and the face wash as well, it was both from Johnson's, both in this even complexion range. This is the day cream with SPF 15. Yeah, so I just want to say that even the addition of a face cream to my skincare routine is phenomenal, because I literally wash my face in the shower and then I apply the same cocoa butter lotion that I put on my body onto my face as well, and that's literally been my skincare routine. So what I'm doing now is I've just used the Maybelline baby skin instant pore eraser as a primer, and so yeah, applying the primer helps kind of make your face appear smoother. I mean, that's what I believe, but yeah, also don't judge me, but I don't have a foundation at the moment. If somebody wants to send me a foundation, the MAC foundation is beautiful, the one with the liquid. My shade is NC44.5. You know, slide in my DMs, hit me up with an email, anything. I'll send you through my daytime delivery address, and you know, you can just hook a girl up. Because at the moment, like I said, I don't have a foundation. I am currently using two stick foundations. They're even different brands. And one is super light, you can see the one that I'm putting on now. This is a L'Oreal Infallible. I don't know if I'll put it in the description, but I'll tag it in the video. And this one is another one that I got, I think, at like Foschini or something, and it is called Mocha. And what I've been doing is I've literally been putting it on my face like so. Put another one over here. Putting on my face like so, and then using a little brush and just blending it all together. And it does kind of match my skin tone, I don't know, maybe. And it gives me a nice coverage. I am like not serious about this life. I would love to be more serious about the makeup life, but I don't know, man. I feel like makeup is expensive. And I don't know, maybe you guys can let me know of some affordable makeup brands that are good quality that I should look into getting some products from. So, about tonight, I'm so excited, guys. I am going to the Sam Smith concert, and like, I am a huge Sam Smith fan. Last year, a friend of ours and his wife went to the Sam Smith concert in Paris for their anniversary, and I was so jealous. I was super jealous because I love Sam Smith. And then, like, also last year, the week of my birthday, they announced that Sam Smith will be coming to South Africa this year, and I completely lost my mind. Like, I cried, guys. I literally cried. Oh, I was so excited. I just knew that I needed to be at the concert. Like, if I wasn't at the concert, I would regret it for the rest of my life. If I could, like, I don't have a bucket list, but I could definitely say seeing Sam Smith is on my, or was on or is, yeah, still is, because I'm not there yet, still is on my bucket list, and I would love to, I mean, also on my bucket list is that he'd sing at my wedding, but I mean, let's start small and go bigger later. So, super, super excited. I cried. I told my boyfriend, and then he bought me tickets, guys. I know, God, amazing. So he bought our tickets, and we have such good seats, guys. Like, you'll see. I'll put in clips from the actual concert, like at the end of this, just so you guys can see where we were and what Sam was getting up to. So yeah, okay, I think that's enough of this foundation vibe. I'm really, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm really not big on makeup. I don't know, I'm pretty comfortable in my non-makeup skin. Yeah, that's just ultimately it. It's just that I'm comfortable. Okay, so this the same foundation stick that I mixed with the other one, the dark shade, I'm gonna use for the contour thing. So yeah, like I said, guys, hit me up in them comments and let a girl know what's up in terms of brands to try and things that I'm doing wrong. Like, really, I'm all for constructive criticism. Please make sure it's constructive. Don't just come through, don't just come at me. But yeah, so I think I am interested in learning more about makeup. I've been watching some makeup YouTubers. My favorite is Jackie Aina, and I've only probably seen her videos in the last month or so. And I was like, oh my word, why have I not been following her? Yeah, so I saw her videos, and I love her videos. And another YouTuber that I watch is Patricia Bright. She's amazing, she's hilarious, I love her, I really love her. I could watch her videos like all day, every day. But yeah, anyways, I'm supposed to be talking to you guys about Sam Smith, and I'm talking to you about beauty YouTubers. Yeah, so when the tickets came on sale, I was really stressed, because I was like, okay, cool, if I'm gonna get tickets, I need to make sure that I'm getting them with this Discovery vibe, so that I know I'm getting great tickets, because I've heard before that like, the good tickets or the best tickets get sold to these people, like to the people who buy from Discovery, and then everybody else is kind of left like with the leftover tickets. So I wanted to make sure that we get, okay, so it wasn't a surprise that my boyfriend bought me the tickets. He told me he was gonna buy me the tickets because it was my birthday, and he was like, he's gonna buy me really good tickets because it's my birthday, and that was gonna be the present. I'm also like, what were you gonna buy me before the tickets came on sale? Because tickets literally went on sale the week of my birthday. Yeah, so we actually asked our friend, the guy who went to see Sam Smith in Paris, to let us buy it on his credit card, so that, because he has a Discovery credit card. So he allowed us to buy it, and then we obviously paid, Dato, my boyfriend, he obviously paid him back for the tickets. But yeah, so we made sure we secured the tickets then and there. Okay, how are we feeling about, I don't know, this contour thing that's meant to be here, but I don't know if it's here. I just put the things, and then I hope that it looks good after everything. I don't know if it does. My pictures look good, I hope. The ones on Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, make sure to get on that. My feed be lit. I try, guys. So yeah, so my earliest memories of Sam Smith was on a family vacation to Australia to visit my aunt and her family who live in Australia, and they've been there for forever. And we visited them for the first time since they moved there. It was our first time visiting them as a family. It was actually my 21st birthday present. Like, I was like, for my 21st birthday, let's go visit my aunt in Australia. So, I'm so nice. I'm so nice. My parents obviously paid for it, but yeah, I'm super nice. And I remember when we were there, my aunt really like enjoyed the songs of Sam Smith that we would hear on the radio. That and Ed Sheeran. Somebody gifted her the Ed Sheeran and Sam Smith CDs for Christmas. And so whenever we would do some trips, we would listen to the CDs in the car. And so yeah, that was my first memories of Sam Smith. And I really enjoyed his music from then. I really did. Like, he is such an amazing singer. Such an amazing singer. Like, you can fight me on that. He is an amazing, amazing artist. And then, was it last year? When did the Thrill of It All come out? I think the album released last year. And so, wait guys. I got one of these. So that I wouldn't be leaning like this and stuff. So yeah. Okay, so this is a concealer. There we go. So it's the Wet n Wild one. Wet n Wild, and it is the concealer, and the shade is medium peach. So yeah. Okay, so back to the Thrill of It All. So when that album released, there was a competition on Instagram where you could enter to attend the, is it called an album launch? It's called the listening session. It was the listening session for the album. Yeah guys, I don't know what, like, which brushes to use for what. So I just kind of use whatever I feel like. So I entered that competition on Instagram, and like I said, it was a listening session for the album. So it would be hosted at the Wits Planetarium. And it was called A Night Under the Stars, and it was for the album The Thrill of It All. So I entered that competition and I won, and it was for two tickets. So I took my friend Karis with me, and we went there and we listened to the album, and they had, you know, like the night sky projected and the galaxies projected onto the ceiling if you've never been to the planetarium before. And it was pretty dope. I mean, that album is amazing. My favorite album, my favorite songs off that album are Pray and Him. Those, yeah. I literally listened to that album on repeat for weeks after that. Like, legit, I can legitimately say I listened to it for weeks after that, okay? I don't do my eyebrows. What I normally do is I just brush them, because I have pretty decent eyebrows. They're pretty thick, they've got a decent shape. I normally do thread them, but I only do that when I go to Durban, because I have a guy that I trust in Durban. I've had nightmares with my eyebrows before. I can't do thin eyebrows, and for some reason, I don't know, people just don't get the shape right. Like, obviously my eyebrows are not the same shape. I don't know if that's common with everyone, but mine definitely aren't. And sometimes, like, people literally like do my eyebrows so that the one starts here and then the other one starts here. I'm obviously exaggerating, but literally they don't kind of have the same starting point position, and then the shapes are different, and I've really had nightmares. So I don't usually fill in. I do have a light patch here, but it's not the end of the world, I think. Okay, now I'm gonna use a setting powder. It's another one that I'm still like, I have an idea of what it's meant to do, but then somebody said something to me once and then I was like completely thrown off, and I was like, oh, so that my idea was wrong of what it's meant to do. So maybe somebody could, you know, slide in those comments and just let me know, what does a setting powder do? The foundation part of it done. I don't really do much to my face. Like, even the contouring thing, it was, you know, I try and do it. I don't even know if I'm doing it right, to be honest. I just do whatever. But yeah, so now I'm gonna put on some blush. The blush that I'm using is this one by Maybelline. and it is called brown. Yeah, it says 20 brown, so I guess that's my shade. And you know guys, I must be honest with y'all, you know I said before that like makeup is a bit expensive, or I consider makeup expensive, just because, you know, like I grew up, my mom didn't really wear makeup and she really encouraged us to just be comfortable in our own skins. When I say us, I mean me and my sister. And I think my dad and yeah, my both my parents kind of encouraged us to do that. So we didn't really grow up wearing makeup or being exposed to much makeup. So, you know, all of a sudden as an adult now, people kind of expect you to wear makeup. So yeah, so that was something that was new to me, or that is new to me. So I had to really get used to that whole idea. And honestly, most of the makeup I own is stuff that I've bought on sale. It's stuff that I've got for free in goodie bags. So I'll kind of indicate, because I think that's fun as well. Kind of indicate things that I've bought on special, on sale, or I've gotten for free, or somebody has given to me. My foundation sticks, the one my sister gave to me, the other one I bought on sale. The concealer I bought full price. The primer, I bought that full price as well. And yeah, this Maybelline blush I got for free in a gift bag. So if it looks familiar to somebody else, yeah, it is. It should be familiar, because we all got it, guys. We all got it. I'm not trying to pretend like I am, you know, spending all of this money on makeup when I'm really not. Even this brush, actually, this Kabuki brush, I think it's by Black Opal, and I got it for free in the first ever natural hair event that I attended's goodie bag. Okay, the Switch Beauty brushes that I'm using on my eyebrows right now, I got these on a Black Friday sale. But yeah, okay, so we're done with the face officially. So now we're gonna go on to the eyeshadow, and I have this one that I really love, this eyeshadow palette from Switch Beauty. It's called Top Notch. So I'm gonna go with a neutral eye, like I always do. So I'm gonna use this shade, this one. And this is not the right brush. I mean, as far as I know, it's not the right brush. It might very well have been the right brush, but it's not the right brush for me. So I'm taking this, and then I am going to use my mirror. Unfortunately, there's no mirror on this palette, but I'm gonna DIY it. I'm gonna use my mirror over here, and then I'm just gonna apply it to my eyelid. Okay, so next I'm gonna take this brush and this brown shade, and I'm gonna put it more towards my crease, because you're supposed to put a darker color in your crease. And I'm gonna blend it, because apparently that's also a phrase that gets thrown around in this makeup space. So guys, I'm not gonna lie, this get ready with me thing is very difficult to shoot, because it's literally like I'm talking to myself, and for the life of me, I can't think of another topic to bring up right now. What topics do you find intriguing or captivating? Maybe you guys should give me some topics. I mean, I'm not promising that I'm gonna do another get ready with me, because I highly doubt that I'm gonna do another get ready with me. But if I ever decide that I want to do another get ready with me, what are some good topics to talk about? Like, do you like it when people talk about current affairs or celebrity gossip, or what, sports? I don't know, are you into sports? I am so plain when it comes to makeup. Sure, we're going with it. So I find that the more metallic shades actually transfer better with if I use my finger. So I'm gonna take this rose goldish one that's over here. It's like a bronzy rose gold.
And I usually just do it to like mid crease, like that. I'm sure all the makeup
YouTubers out there that are watching my video, because I'm sure all of the makeup YouTubers are out there watching my video, are cringing at what's happening in this video. But really, guys, at the end of the day, I don't know, my face looks fine when I leave the house, I think. Yeah, so when I'm feeling really fancy, I'll take this brush, like it's like a really stiff one, and I'll put it there, and then I will just apply some of the same eyeshadow along my bottom eyelid. Okay, so now onto one of my absolute favorite, and I'm not even being sarcastic when I say, like, this is one of my absolute favorite parts about putting on makeup, and it is liquid liner. And the one that I'll be using today is one that y'all should be pretty familiar with. It's a local South African makeup line, and it's Switch Beauty, and this is their liquid luck eyeliner. I've used quite a few different eyeliner brands, and yeah, like, they're like, I really like this pin, kind of pin tip cokey pin applicator. It makes it really easy to apply, and it's just kind of like, so you just kind of outline. I do very, very, oh, that's gonna be a problem. That's on my eyelash. Okay. Huh, this one's bleeding a lot. That's not great. Okay, let's reassess the situation. Okay, let's see if we can salvage it. I'm using the new ink with the old eyeliner pen. Can you see it? Yeah, there you go. It doesn't look terrible. I mean, from far, I don't think anybody's gonna really be up in my face about it. So I'm gonna, yeah. And I really like to get into my, kind of by my tear duct. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I'm gonna use some of this micellar cleansing water and an earbud, and I'm just gonna clean this up a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna do the other eye off camera because that was super stressful. Okay, cool, so I'm back. The eyeliner is done. It's much better on the, it's my left, it's my right. It's much better on my left eye. Probably because I wasn't under pressure. But yeah, last but not least, because the girl has no eyelashes, but also no skill to apply a false eyelash, I have the Maybelline The Falsies Volume Express Mascara. So it's this purple one. It's amazing, I love it. It has a really cool wand, and that's it for eyes. Okay guys, my sister really blessed me. She went to Australia in December and she got me some things from Sephora, and this right here is my pretty girl swag. This is my Fenty Beauty, this beauty right here. It's amazing. Yeah, I'm gonna live my best life with my Fenty Beauty. I'm also not gonna go crazy with it because there only needs to be one star tonight, and that's Sam Smith, so I can't steal the spotlight from him with this bomb highlighter. Yep. That is it. That is it. That's all. Last but not least, my Kiki Beauty SA makeup setting spray. And we're done. We're done. D-O-N-E. Oh wait, I need a lip thing. Yeah, I don't know. We'll figure that one out later. But as far as my hair is concerned, I did a wash and go yesterday, and the products that I used are South African, and it's called Femme de Karité, and I used their leave-in, and I used their styling cream. And if you're interested in seeing how I applied those products, or learning more about like how I actually applied this to my hair, then obviously let me know in the comment section below. But I also will be sharing my wash day series stories on Instagram. Yeah, and that's it. I mean, that's my hair. That's what I'm doing with it today. It's got some curly bangs. And I will see you guys at the concert.